MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's game one of the National League Division Series between the Milwaukee Brewers and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Clayton Kershaw will do the pitching in front of the hometown crowd here in game one. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
Here's the second baseman, Colton Wong, and we are set for baseball here this evening. The 1-1 home. Trying to bunt his way on base here, but this will roll foul. Kershaw is way up there among active pitchers in terms of career wins. He's earned more than 170 of them in his time at the big leagues. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. And now to the plate, Lorenzo Cain.
Lorenzo Cain.
One out, nobody on. Hit to first. And he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Next for Milwaukee, Christian Yelich. A fastball well off the plate inside. Changeup called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2.
Very rarely does a pitcher like this leave one in a location like that. That's a pitch right there he'd like to have back. He'd love to swing at that one again.
2-2 is looked at, and the count moves forward.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some credit there. Sometimes with two strikes, you're more.
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Three up, three down for Milwaukee. And now the Dodgers get a crack at it. No score. Corbin Burns gets the call in hostile territory here for game one of the division series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matt, this guy also uses that pitch that's kind of in vogue in the game now, that cutter. It looks to the hitter like a four-seam fastball, and the next thing you know, it's running in on you. Mariano Rivera used that pitch exclusively in the ninth inning and broke a lot of bats, and this guy joins a long list of guys that have added the cutter to his repertoire.
Striding in is Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Here it comes. Swing and a miss got him reaching. The throw to first is in time, one down.
Batting second.
So one out and nobody aboard. And striding to the plate will be Corey Seager. Bases are empty, one man out. Two balls and two strikes to Corey Seager. Grounded to the right. Taken in by Wong. And there are two away now.
Batting third. The third baseman. Justin Turner.
Ready now is Justin Turner, looking to get on base and keep standing alive. Bases are empty here with two men out. Ball. And this is low, ball two. Two and one. Turner in front at three balls and a strike.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down one, two, three, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
To the left side, but it's well fouled. Now the 3-2 pitch. And a pitch swung on and bounced to Arcia at short. Over to first, and that retires the side. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. And this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. And now, Keston Hiura. He'll be the one to start things here against Clayton Kershaw. And the pitch. Hit back toward the mound. And that'll get on by into center field for a leadoff single.
The right field. Opposite side.
To the plate now, Abisail Garcia hit the other way out toward right field. There to look it in his bets, and that's out number one.
That is good. The catcher, number nine, Manny Pena.
Next up, Manny Pena. No score here as we play inning number two. Lifted down the line and left. And that nearly broke our scoreless tie. Instead, it's a foul ball. Skied into straightaway right. Betts has a read on it. Two gone. And with two away now, let's give you a look at the big picture here. There you see the participants in this year's playoffs. Now it'll be Daniel Robertson. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Set. Here comes the 1-1. And there's ball two now. I tried to jerk that one, and it's 2-2. High high set by Kershaw. Now the pitch. Hira, the runner at first with two gone. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time is laid off of for ball number three.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Pitch popped up. Turner is under it near the mound, and that will end the inning. Milwaukee leads one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. Surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And there's one down.
That is good. The catcher.
Here now is Will Smith. Fly ball headed for the corner and left. It has the distance, and it's a foul ball.
Ah, man, just a hair early on that one and just pulled it foul. It's going to have to find a way to refocus. Not easy to continue an AB after you just went deep foul.
The 2-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. And he fouls this one off. Bottom of the second here with no score. And this is a strike three call. Oh, caught a break there. Two away.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Stepping in now, Max Muncy. A bouncer up the middle. Garcia fields it cleanly. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Dodgers down in order. We'll move to the third with no score. Next to bat, Orlando Garcia, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Sticking with the soft stuff here as this misses. It's 2-1.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
2-2. Hit on the ground out to short. Reined in. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Digging in now for the Brewers, Corbin Burns. Third inning, no score to this point. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
3-1 to him now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
Three, two.
hit in the air out to center field. Bellinger's under it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Colton Wong struck out in his first at-bat. A little behind on that swing, and now they'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Counts even at 2-2 to Wong.
What pitch recognition right there. 100% of the guys are going fish after that nasty slider.
Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. Smith recovers, and the throw to first ends the inning. Gone in order are the Brewers. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, A.J. Pollock. Good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
In now, Gavin Lux. And this is Lyon back into center field, and that will be their first hit of the contest.
Batting now, the pitcher, right there, Kershaw.
At the plate now, Clayton Kershaw. He'll take no chances here as he swipes this ball away. It stays a foul ball. A square to bunt, and it's popped up. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up Mookie Betts. Out of the stretch, the 3-1 home. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
The batter, number five.
Here's Corey Seager. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here, similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Trying to bury one down and away, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. Down the first baseline. And this will get fouled, so they'll do it again. 3-2. He set the payoff pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Garcia has it on the first, and the Dodgers come up with nothing as that ends the inning. Dodgers strand a couple. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Into the box, Lorenzo Cain. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
Oh, you have to love. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low-scoring pitcher's duel for once.
That was a nasty pitcher's pitch right there. Most guys strike out on that one. He was able to scramble out a little bit and give him another chance. And hopefully this pitcher misses over the heart of the plate.
Seager backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out. Digging in will be Christian Yelich. 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up.
You know, Matty, tough to go down looking right there, especially in a long at bat. I kind of tip my hat to the fact that he didn't go into uber swing mode. He battled. He just got locked up. Look for him to have another quality AB. I think he's seeing the ball pretty darn big right now.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
Still 2-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time.
I got 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Fouled off. And it's fouled away. Another full count pitch home. Bouncer to the left side. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first to take care of him. And Kershaw's in control now. Two away. The bases are empty here with two away. And in at the plate steps Keston Hiura. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And this one misses inside a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, they've been unable to get to this guy, so they'll take base runners any way they can get him. At the very least, you make him work from the stretch and add to his pitch total.
So two down and a runner at first, and that'll bring up Avisail Garcia. Swings through it for strike number two. Hiura leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Brewers strand one onto the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the veteran third baseman, Justin Turner. On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now. Chance here for the second baseman, Wong. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out. So here's Cody Bellinger. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And there's a line drive, base hit to left field. Through first and hustling for second.
And this is just a cut fastball. He's trying to sneak in the back door. He's unable to get it done. Leaves it right over the heart of the plate. And that's just too easy for a guy like this. He's licking his chops as the ball arrives. And he drills it to the outfield for an extra base hit.
So now to the plate, Will Smith. Just low that time with the heavy sinker as it's ruled ball three.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
Now back, first baseman.
Next up for Los Angeles, Max Muncy grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Now a swing and he pops him up. And I believe, yes, the umpire signaling for the infield fly rule. Stepping in next, A.J. Pollock. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. No runs, two hits, no errors for the Dodgers thus far. Hit back up the middle. Garcia gloves it. And the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Dodgers strand a couple. Through four. Still tied. Nothing, nothing. Back now at Fenway Park, and here's Heidi Watney with a report.
Well, Matt, during the break, I caught up with Craig Counsell, the Brewers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Manny Pena. Now the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
I'll tell you, he looks really dialed in on the bump right there. He's got a shutout going, and he really seems to have this lineup off balance. Even when he challenges them up in the zone, they don't have an answer for it.
Standing in now, Daniel Robertson. Popped up. Lux waits on it. And that's the second out of the inning.
Now batter.
So the bases are empty with two gone now. And up next will be the shortstop, Orlando Arcia. The 3-1 pitch. Misses inside a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
That's a nice job to work that walk right there. Even if it doesn't lead to anything on the scoreboard this inning, it prevents the pitcher from having to lead off of the next one. Just one of those small things that might go unnoticed, but in the end, make a big difference.
Runner at first with two gone in the inning, and in to hit next will be Corbin Burns. Didn't threaten the zone there. Looked like it might have actually popped out of his hand a little early. He's falling behind now, 3-1.
This is a big bat right here. No doubt you'd rather go after the nine-hole hitter with a runner on third instead of giving the top of the order a chance to cash in.
The 3-1 hit in the air down the right field line. On the move is Betts. He gets there to make the play, and that ends the inning. Milwaukee leaves one. Halfway home, still no score. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and up next will be Gavin Lux. The 2-1 home.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
Here's the payoff pitch. And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
So here's the Dodgers pitcher, Clayton Kershaw, who dropped a sacrifice bunt in his last plate appearance.
And the way he executed, Matty, can't imagine anything other than him getting another bunt down. In this situation, potential go-ahead run, put him in scoring position, please.
2-1 the count. Lux on at first, nobody out. Up the bunt attempt. And he will not have a play behind him. It's an infield single. They'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now. Into the box, Mookie Betts. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Looking to punch him out again. Pitch. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. Long for one. On to first. A double play.
Oh, that's a rally killer right there. They were in great shape with two on and nobody out. But the double play is the last thing you want in that situation. Just a runner at third now, but there's two outs.
Plate now, Corey Seager. I'm trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes. Mine to the right side, and a base hit as the run will come in to score from third, and a 1-0 lead for the Dodgers.
Boy, it's been tough to score in this one so far through the fifth inning, but that RBI base hit right there is a nice breakthrough.
Yeah, it's been a great pitcher's duel up until this point. They've been executing on the bump without question, but that RBI knock right there might set the tone for later innings.
Into the box now, Justin Turner. Ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside. Fouls this one off. A runner on first with two away. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. A run on two hits and they leave one. Set for the start of the inning, and that'll give way to the second baseman, Colton Wong. Swing and a liner. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard. So So only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, man, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
Here's a look over to first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. In now, Lorenzo Cain, hit pretty well out toward right center field. There to look it in his bats, and that's out number one. So a runner at first now with one away, and up next, the sweet swinging left-handed hitting outfielder Christian Yelich. Second, fouled off. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. And they take the lead. It's gone. Two-run blast to straightaway right field, and the Brewers take a 2-1 lead.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Keston Hiura. Fly ball right down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
Man, I love watching the pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch. And for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Stepping in now, Avisail Garcia. Hit out toward second. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. But the Brewers do get two on this two-run home run. Bottom of the sixth coming up, 2-1 Milwaukee. Your Brett Anderson please. Enters to do the now pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 25, Brett Anderson.
Cody Bellinger at the plate now. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. The 1-1 home. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Their count now at 2-2. Full count to Bellinger, three balls, two strikes.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. So the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Next for the Dodgers, Will Smith. It was a walk in his last trip. even at a ball and a strike. Here's the pitch. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now.
Hey, you know in the back of your mind as a batter right here, he's got that nasty sinker. I know it's 0-2, but he might not be looking for the punch out. You have to find a way as a batter to get that two-seamer up in the zone, or you're going to ground into a double play.
And a half swing that time, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the umpire, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
Now that.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. Into the corner and slicing foul. Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. And he lays off here. Nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away.
Well, when you go with the slider there at a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Next, here is A.J. Pollock trying here to plate the tying run from second. The 1-1. Hit sharply on the ground. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Now a long throw home. But this won't be in time as he's well safe and the run scores.
The bat, number nine, second baseman.
Standing in now, Gavin Lux. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Swing and a liner. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out. Chris Taylor will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number three, Brett Taylor.
Hit at third. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And a close play at the bag, but a good stretch by the first baseman got the out, and the inning is over. Just one hit in the inning, but it was a big one right here as it ties the ball game. The 6-7-8 hitters coming up to start the seventh, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Corey Knebel is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 46, Corey Knebel.
New inning set to get underway, and next to hit is the catcher, Manny Pena. The 1-1. And a jam shot here as this is sent towards second. He's got it. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. So next to hit is Daniel Robertson. His head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel. Small sample, a perfect one for one. The 1-2.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against a modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
Set. Here's the 2-2. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. The 2-2. Swing and a high fly ball out to left field. Catch made out there by Pollock, and there are two away now. Stepping up is Orlando Arcia. It was a walk in his last trip. The 1-1. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. Two out, nobody on. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul.
Nope,
just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
And it's fouled away. Here's another 2-2.
Helpful.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count. He just seems to keep hanging right in there.
Count still full, 3-2. Payoff pitch one more time. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Narvaez come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 10.
Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Liner toward right center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. And that's going to move that go-ahead run to second now with two gone.
Up next from Milwaukee.
Into the box, Colton Wong sent on the ground out to second. Scooped up on to first, and the Brewers are turned away as the inning is over. The Brewers strand a couple. Score remains 2-2. Eric Yardley will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 57, Eric Yardley.
Bottom of the inning now, and up next, one of the terrific talents in the game, Mookie Betts. Now the 2-1. Line, that's a base hit in the left field. So the Dodgers get their leadoff hitter on base to kick off the inning.
Man, that's a nice job by the batter right there, keeping the front side in. Not easy on a curveball. Would have been easy to throw the front side and hook that foul, but he was able to stay inside and drive it for a base hit.
For the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. At the plate now, Corey Seager, right to him. One there on the first, and you can forget about the go-ahead run being on base. He's erased on the double play.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
To the plate now, Justin Turner. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Well, those were a couple of close pitches right there in the inner part of the zone. Hitters will tell you, pitches in that location are tough to do anything with.
Two and two.
Two strikes.
you have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
To first, reined in. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here, and this game is still tied at 2-2. Joe Kelly has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 17, Joe Kelly.
And in to hit next is Lorenzo Cain. The 1-1. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. That time got him swinging, and that's the first out.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and has backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
And now Christian Yelich. He lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Now batting the first baseman, Keston Hill.
So a runner at first now with one away, and in at the plate steps Keston Hill. The catch. And stepping in, Avisail Garcia. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. One and one. Here it is. And now some action in that Dodger bullpen as a left-hander has begun to get loose. Delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first, and he'll dive back in safely. The set and the 2-1, hard hit towards center. Bellinger will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Brewers strand one, score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Set to go. And digging in is the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. He's set. Here's the 2-2.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters. So you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Now the payoff pitch home. Bounce to first, fielded cleanly, and they'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. So next to bat will be Will Smith, 0-2 with a couple of strikeouts for him so far. One out, nobody on. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Long is there. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out.
Now back.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. It was a walk in his last trip. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Oh. 1-2 pitch. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Nothing across here this half. We're on to the ninth here in game one, and we are tied 2-2. All set to start the ninth in this one, and now it'll be the catcher, Manny Pena. The 1-2. Hard hit ball to second, scooped up. Throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag.
This is a head-scratcher. I mean, that's the shortest throw on the infield, and somehow he lets it sail wide of the mark for an E4. A couple more like that, and doubt starts to creep into the second baseman's mind.
So here is Daniel Robertson. Go-ahead run at first. Nobody out. Two pitch.
Ball two.
To two balls and two strikes now.
Wow, that was a close pitch on 1-2. The count's now at 2-2, but boy, that one very easily could have been called strike three. Really close pitch.
Popped him up. Seager, stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone. Now to the plate, here is Orlando Arcia. It's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. The 3-1 pitch. Count full, three balls and two strikes. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Swing and a miss. Looked like the knuckle curve there, and that's out number two. Victor Gonzalez will summon here, and we'll try to keep this one tied heading to the bottom of the ninth.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Dodgers, number 81, Victor Gonzalez.
Tyrone Taylor will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Ready with the 2-1. Now a swing as he shoots this down the right field line. And this will bounce over the wall out there, and that's going to keep this a tie ball game as that go-ahead run will need to stop over at third.
When you play in this park where the fences are shorter, this is going to happen more often than any other ballparks.
Into the box now. Colton Wong skied in the air to straightaway left. Is there now to put this one away for the third out as they'll strand that potential go-ahead run at third base. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. We're back with more of Game 1 after this message and a word from our local stations. Brent Suter enters to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra innings. Late now is A.J. Pollock. He delivered an RBI single in his last trip. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him. 1-2. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 1-2. He's at the knees and called strike three.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Stepping in now, Gavin Lux. Outside, 2-1. Bases are empty, one man. ball even now, 2-2. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
One pitch is a curveball that misses ball two.
Ball
3-1. Mookie Betts would be next if they can keep this inning alive. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Into the windup, the payoff pitch. And a great inning here as he gets another punch out and strikes out the side in order. So a pitching clinic there as he sets them down in order all via the punch out. Back with more from game one after this. Scott Alexander takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings.
Number 75, Scott Alexander.
We are into extra innings, and next it'll be the outfielder, Lorenzo Cain. Here now the 2-2. Lifted in the air to center field. Bellinger's under it, and that's the first out of the inning. Set for the start of the inning, coming forward the veteran outfielder, Christian Yelich. One-one. Swung out and missed for strike number two. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Comes on a ball and two strikes. And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now.
That's what you call clipping the outside corner. Great movement on that slider, and it completely locked up the hitter. Didn't fool the umpire, though.
Into the box, Keston Hiura. Hit on the ground out to short. He's right there. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. Three up, three down for Milwaukee. Score remains 2-2. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here, and that'll bring up Mookie Betts. Lifted down the line and left. Yelich is under it. And that's the first out of the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And up next, the former All-Star shortstop, Corey Seager. Pulled toward right center field. Kane is under it. Two gone. Next to hit is Justin Turner. Prior history in this matchup, he's one for two. inside and a hair low. It's two balls and two strikes. Fouled away. Two and two, the pitch. Cody Bellinger would be next. Here's the payoff pitch. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he fouls this one off. Hit down the line at first. Reined in. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. And this game is still tied at 2-2. Now to bat, Avisail Garcia. And he'll be the one to get the 11th underway. Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2.
Whoa, he was swinging out of his shoes on that changeup. Must have looked real good coming in, but a different story once it got near the plate.
And he'll break through with a solid knock here, his first of the ballgame. So the Brewers get their leadoff man aboard to start out the frame. And we'll take a look into that Dodger bullpen, as with matchup problems looming, we'll see if they decide to make a move here. So now to the plate, Manny Pena got it back in time there, and it's 2-1. Trying to get that go-ahead run to scoring position now as he puts this one down. Return throw gets him at first. It's a 3-6-1 double play.
That's good athleticism here by the pitcher getting off the mound. He gets the ball to first and then hustles his way over to the bag to help him wrap up the tough 3-6-1 double play.
Luis Urias gets the call as a pinch hitter, and he'll get a chance with two out and the bases empty. Back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Two out, nobody on. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. He's set. The 2-2. Swing and a liner. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. Now, Orlando Arcia, rocket to third, and that's in for a base hit, make it a 1-for-3 game so far. And if you're wondering what's left on the Milwaukee bench, there you get a look at it right there. We'll see if one of those gentlemen is pressed into action here. Travis Shaw will start to loosen up in the on-deck circle as he'll bat with two on and two out here.
Travis Shaw.
Ready with the 1-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. And the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. Brewers strand a couple. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Luis Urias remains in the game playing third after entering the game as a pinch hitter in the previous half inning. Justin Topa takes over now to start the home 11th, and he's looking to get this one to the visiting 12th.
Number 56, Justin Topa.
Set now for the bottom of the 11th, and that'll bring forward Cody Bellinger. The 1-1. Down the third baseline. Here comes the 1-2. Now a drive to right field. This could do it. Game over. Walk-off home run. A solo shot down the line and right, and none bigger than that one as this ball game is over.
Postseason always seems to deliver big moments, and this was no exception. A walk-off in the final at bat ends it, and there's bedlam at home plate. Wow!
The finish in tonight's game, the Los Angeles Dodgers jump out to a 1-0 series lead. Scott Alexander earns the victory on the mound, so that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Here now is our final line.